For starters, we will be using nail monomer. We will also be using a nail top coat as well as a Kalinske brush. We will also be using extra long C-curve tips as well as a UV lamp. In order to get this experiment going, we need some acrylic powders or some nail polishes. For the first part of this experiment, I will be using acrylic powders. And the nail finger is optional. To start off, we will pour a little bit of the nail liquid monomer into a small dappin dish. Once we have our dappin dish set, we will be getting our small C-tip nail as well as our finger in order to place the tip inside the finger so we could begin the experiment. Now we will choose our desired acrylic powder. I will be using Glam & Glitz Mood Effect Acrylic Collection, and we will be opening it up. We must next grab our Kalinske brush in order to grab the product with the monomer and the powder into the nail tip. There should be a 40 to 60 ratio of monomer and product used on the nail tip. We will gently apply the acrylic onto the nail tip. Once we are done applying the acrylic powder, we will be using an ultimate finish gel, which is the top coat that we will put before we place it in under the UV lamp. Once the nail is fully covered with the ultimate finish gel, we will bring out our UV lamp and place our nail tip inside the UV lamp for a cycle. We will only do one cycle of 60 seconds. Once it is done, we take the nail out and it should be a different color, and now it is time to test the experiment with ice. We will be grabbing a little bit of ice and placing it on the nail for a few seconds to see if the color changes. As soon as the nail touches the ice, the color changes instantly. It was tested multiple times in order to see if the color would still change instantly on other sides of the nail. To finish this experiment, we also decided to use ice water to complete it. We place the nail inside the water for 3 seconds, and once we take it out, the full nail should be a different color.
To start off this experiment, we're going to use Concord grape juice, or just any grape juice in general, some alcohol, this one we're using 70%, and some powdered turmeric. We will also be using baking soda and a bit of water. Combining these two together, we're going to take equal parts of water and of baking soda and mix these thoroughly into a bowl. As for the experiment that I decided to choose, we did 2 tablespoons of water and 2 tablespoons of baking soda, or in this case, 2 spoonfuls, just to ensure that it was an even and thorough mixture. Following this step, you will mix the mixture until it has come to an even paste. We will then take our Q-tip and dip it in this baking soda and water mixture. When doing this, you will be able to write whatever message you want. In this case, we wrote "Hi Chem 1B" in the baking soda mixture. This process will also be repeated with the turmeric uncovering, which is why we wrote turmeric on this piece of paper. While the paper is drying, add into a bowl the grape juice that you had. This will be used to uncover the ink. Once you notice that your paper is dry, go ahead and dip your Q-tip into your grape juice and begin to uncover your message. As you can see, this one did not work as well for us, but you can see the blue outline of this subtle word. Flipping from front and back, I attempted to see if this would help uncover the ink better. It did not. But for the most part, the experiment did work. Ooh, I can't ever change without you. You reflect me, I love that about you. And if I could, I would look at us all the time. Just with your hand in my hand, in a pocket full of soap, I can tell you there's no place we could go. As for the second uncoverings of baking soda, mix together about a teaspoon of turmeric into a bowl, along with your alcohol, which is just going to be any amount that you choose. You'll mix this until it becomes a paste, and then you will dip your Q-tip in it and rub it over to uncover your secret message. This was the end result, and as you can see, one worked better than the other.
For this experiment, you will need a lemon, any size will do, a knife to help cut it, a measuring cup to measure the juice squeezed out from the lemon, a bowl to pour it in, cotton swabs to pick and write with, cardstock paper, white would be preferred, but light gray or gray will do. And you will then need an iron so you can transfer heat into the paper. First, you start off by cutting the lemon. Anyway, we'll do. Squeeze the lemon into a measuring cup, making sure you don't squirt any lemon outside the cup. Quickly catch the seeds. And make sure that you squeeze pretty good, getting as much lemon juice out of it. Almost about a full quarter of a cup. Next, you will want to pour it in into your bowl. Now, you using your cotton swab and your lemon juice, gather some and write your message on your cardstock paper. Make sure you write your message in the center of the paper. It will be harder to heat up afterwards if you're writing in the corners as opposed to writing it in the middle. After letting the lemon dry for 5 to 10 minutes, start heating up the iron. Make sure you have it on the highest setting without any vapor. Once your iron's ready to go, begin by the left side of your paper and slowly let it sit, as the paper and the lemon requires a bit of heat so the oxidation can begin. Slowly move it across by a little. Once again, make sure your iron's at the highest setting